I'm Jessica Mitten for IB Times TV, and joining me today is Jason Weisberg of Seaport Securities to give us a preview of what we should be expecting this week on the earnings calendar. So Jason, obviously there's a lot of big companies like Disney, Time Warner coming out with earnings, but we are getting more into the retail sector as well, with Michael Kors, Ralph Lauren, and JCPenney all reporting this week. So now that this is for the second quarter between April and the June period, will this give us more of a picture of how companies and consumers have been affected by the tax hikes in January and then the sequestration cuts in March?
Well, I guess there could be some ties and some connecting of the dots in their earnings. But that being said, I don't think that you should place too much weight into the sequestration and in people's spending habits. I think that this quarter might be a little soft for them. No big surprises, but I think, you know, people are getting ready for holiday sales and back to school sales, and I think that's already starting to be reflected in their stock prices. And unless there's big disappointment in those earnings, I wouldn't expect to see much beta come out of those results.
Do you think that much of the premium that is built into stocks is heavily based on the Fed stimulus program?
I think that what you see now is the market is telling you what's coming. For the market, historically, has been a leading indicator. Stimulus is going away. The equity markets are telling you that the economy is going to get better here in the United States, and that's what people need to focus on. It's actually very exciting that the government will no longer play a hand in what we used to call free market capitalism.
Finally, we did see some upbeat economic data in the service sector for the U.S. today. Do you think that we will see sort of a pickup for the third quarter, or do we really need to focus on more of a pattern with this data?
I think jobs data is really very gray. It's never been a black and white thing. And now we used to have really one jobs number, then it became two. And now we have like a plethora of jobs numbers. And I think that if people focus on the corporate earnings, when they make their investment decisions, and place a little less weight on some of the government data points that come out, certainly about jobs. I mean, some data points that the government gives us are very critical, but the jobs numbers are really gray and they constantly get revised. And I would just focus on the earnings.